Hi, I'm Bob Getty, and I want to take a moment to introduce this tape. It's a gift from us here at your dealership. We sold you the vehicle, and now we're going to help you keep it in like-new condition by servicing it for you. The tape is loaded with information about owning and operating your new Chevrolet, and how to keep it on the road for years to come. There's an explanation of maintenance you can do yourself, like checking engine fluids, as well as service that we're equipped to handle for you, like oil changes and other regular scheduled maintenance. Our service department is here to help you. Get to know us. Ask us any questions you might have about the operation and maintenance of your new vehicle. Now sit back and watch the tape. And then, please give us your comments by filling out and returning the enclosed survey. Enjoy your new Chevrolet and this videotape. Come see us soon. And from Mr. Goodwrench. We're serious about putting service back in the service department.
Quality, performance, power, and versatility. That's today's Chevrolet truck. The people at Chevrolet who designed your truck and the dealership where you bought it and will take it for service would like you to have this video as a gift. It's going to help you get to know your new Chevrolet truck and give you some tips on how to protect your investment by keeping it in top condition. The tape has important information about your truck's special features, GM's outstanding vehicle warranty program, and on how to keep your vehicle looking great and running right. With this video, the information booklets that came with your truck and help from your dealer service representative, you'll learn what you need to know about today's Chevrolet truck, one of the best built, best engineered trucks on the road today. Let's start with two vital sources of information that were delivered with your new Chevrolet truck: your warranty information booklet and your owner's manual, which includes the maintenance schedule. After you've read them, keep them in the vehicle for easy reference. Now let's get rolling, beginning with some information about how to start up your new Chevrolet truck. Your truck is equipped with a computer-controlled electronic fuel pump that's primed and ready to go the instant you turn the key. You don't have to pump the gasoline pedal. In cold weather, if the engine doesn't start within 3 to 5 seconds, depress the accelerator pedal a quarter of the way with the ignition on until the engine starts and continues running. If the engine doesn't start, wait 15 seconds. Then press the pedal to the floor and crank the engine for no more than 15 seconds. More than that could overheat and damage the starter motor. The starting procedures for Chevrolet trucks equipped with carbureted or diesel engines are different. Check your owner's manual if your vehicle is so equipped. Give your Chevrolet truck a few seconds to idle before driving. This will allow the fluids to warm up and circulate, especially on those cold mornings. Now, release the parking brake and you're ready to go. There are a few things to keep in mind during the first few hundred miles of driving your new truck. First, your Chevrolet truck doesn't need an elaborate braking schedule, but make sure not to drive at any one speed, fast or slow, for the first 500 miles. The moving parts will adjust to each other better. Try to avoid making hard stops for the first couple of hundred miles. This will establish an even wear pattern on the brake pads. Finally, since the new pistons, rings, and other engine parts are breaking in, your truck may consume a little oil at first. Remember to check the oil every time you get gasoline, especially during the first few thousand miles. Follow these few simple guidelines and your new Chevrolet truck will be on the road for a long time to come. Remember, everything you need to know about starting and braking in your new truck is explained in detail in your owner's manual. It's the primary source of information about your new Chevrolet truck. Now, let's talk about your warranty, what's covered and what's not covered. The warranty coverage has three major components: GM's basic 3-year, 36,000-mile bumper-to-bumper plus coverage, the 6-year, 100,000-mile corrosion coverage, and the 5-year, 50,000-mile emission defect and emission performance coverage. For California vehicles, selected emission components are covered for 7 years or 70,000 miles, and the remainder are covered for 3 years or 50,000 miles, whichever comes first. Check your warranty booklet to determine coverage for each component. The GM Bumper to Bumper Plus coverage protects the entire truck, bumper to bumper, except for tires and wear items like brake pads, clutch linings, and maintenance items such as engine oil, filters, PCV valves, and coolant. Your truck is covered for any malfunction due to defects in materials or workmanship during the first 3 years or 36,000 miles, whichever comes first. There are no deductibles. Warranty repairs, including towing, parts, and labor, will be made at no charge. Ask your dealer for details on an extended service contract, such as the General Motors Protection Plan, which may extend your truck's base coverage and provide towing and road service. The body of your truck is protected by GM's 6-year, 100,000-mile corrosion coverage against perforation caused by rust. Any sheet metal panel that rusts through due to corrosion during that time period will be repaired or replaced. But remember, your truck's warranty, like any new truck warranty, covers malfunction and defects, not damage caused by accident, abuse, or improper maintenance. For instance, the 6-year, 100,000-mile corrosion warranty does not cover surface rust caused by stone chips or other damage. That's an important point. Your truck was built to last, and General Motors backs it with strong warranty coverage. But it's up to you to take care of your new truck properly. That's why both preventive and regular scheduled maintenance are so important. Here's an important warranty tip. Whenever you have your truck serviced, save the service receipt and be sure that it clearly indicates what service was performed and when. Keep a record of the maintenance in your GM maintenance schedule. If you ever do need warranty service, it's good to have records showing that your truck has been properly maintained. Any Chevrolet service department will perform warranty repairs, but we recommend going back to the dealership where you purchased your truck. And if you have any questions about your warranty or need information about warranty repairs, call the Customer Assistance Center toll-free at 800-222-1020. Our representatives will answer any questions you may have about your new vehicle and help you understand exactly how your new Chevrolet is covered. Because emergencies are unpredictable, it's important to help protect yourself each time you get into your truck. We're talking about using your safety belts. Use your safety belts. They save lives and reduce injury. Your owner's manual answers many of the questions you may have about proper safety belt use. Here are some important tips. Wear the belt across your chest, not under your arm. The lap belt should be as low on the hips as possible. Make sure it's buckled into its proper latch plate, not the one next to it. And keep the belt free of twists. Make a visual check of your safety belts periodically. Torn or damaged belts may come apart when you need them most. If the safety belt light comes on while you're driving, or if it doesn't go off after starting your truck and you're buckled up, take it to your dealer's service department and have the system checked. Otherwise, you might not have the protection you're counting on in an emergency. A few more safety tips. Make sure those doors are locked whenever the truck is underway. Locking the doors helps to keep them closed in a collision. And if your truck has head restraints, adjust them up or down to a point closest to the top of your ears. We want you to arrive safely every time you're on the road, so make sure to use all your vehicle's safety equipment properly. Your new truck was built to deliver top performance, and your dealer is ready to help keep it that way. But you can help too by following the fuel requirements spelled out in your owner's manual. Think of good fuel as a good investment for your truck's high-output engine. For gasoline-powered engines, that means filling up with unleaded detergent gasoline with an octane rating at least as high as what's recommended in your owner's manual. and fuel-containing detergent helps protect the fuel injectors in your engine from clogging up. Check the gasoline pump for both octane rating and detergent information. If you use the recommended grade and type of gasoline and give your truck regular dealer maintenance, you shouldn't need additional additives. Here's a fill-up tip. When you remove the gasoline cap, turn it counterclockwise and wait for any hissing noise to stop before unscrewing it all the way. Removing the cap too quickly may cause gasoline to spray out at you. Remember, gasoline vapors are highly flammable, so don't smoke when you're near gasoline or refueling. Finally, here are some fuel economy tips. Following them can save money by breaking those gas-consuming bad habits. Avoid jackrabbit stops and starts, zooming from one traffic light to the next and then screeching to a halt. Try not to idle for long periods of time. Be sure to keep your tires inflated properly as specified in your owner's manual. Combine many short trips into one by planning your itinerary. If your truck is equipped with cruise control, use it on long trips whenever conditions allow. It makes driving easier, and it's a more economical way to drive. And finally, maintain the truck according to the schedule that came with it. We'll go into regular scheduled maintenance in a few minutes. All the maintenance and service your new truck needs can be handled in your dealer's service department. But there are a few things you can do to help keep your new truck running right. Let's go over some of the more important owner maintenance points with a quick tour under the hood. If your Chevrolet truck comes equipped with a prop rod, be sure to secure it properly whenever working under the hood. The important checkpoints are easy to find, though the locations may vary slightly, depending on the Chevrolet truck model you own. All the dipsticks and fluid filler caps are clearly marked. The coolant recovery tank should be checked at each fill-up. The windshield washer reservoir should also be checked at each fill-up. Be aware that in bad weather, you'll be using the windshield washer more frequently, so be sure to keep an eye on the level and add fluid when necessary. The power steering fluid reservoir. Check this twice yearly. The engine oil dipstick and filler cap. The oil dipstick is your most frequent checkpoint because oil is one of the most critical engine fluids. Oil lubricates and helps cool the moving parts inside your engine. Keeping it fresh and up to level is critical to engine health. Be sure to check the engine oil level on a regular basis. The best time is when the engine is warm, after it's been operating a while. Wait a few moments after you shut off the engine so that the oil can drain back into the pan and give you an accurate check. Remove the oil dipstick, then wipe it clean. Push it all the way back in, then remove it again, keeping the tip down. The level should be within the safe range shown here. But if the oil level is at or below the add line here, add a quart of the type of engine oil recommended in the engine oil section of your owner's manual. Keep in mind that it's normal for an engine to consume a little oil, especially engines like yours, which are designed to run at a relatively high operating temperature. Don't overfill the engine with oil. Too much oil can cause damage. And remember to push the dipstick all the way back in when you replace it in the engine. Your new truck is also equipped with a Delco Freedom battery. Its sophisticated design means you do not have to add water to it. You can check the level of the engine coolant by looking at the see-through coolant recovery tank, located here on this model. This is very important. Never open the radiator cap when the engine is hot or even warm. The hot steam under pressure can burn you. Check the coolant at the coolant recovery tank when the engine is warm or cool. You'll see the full hot and add level markings on the tank. If the coolant level is low, remove the top from the recovery tank and add a mixture that's half water and half ethylene glycol antifreeze. After you've checked the coolant level, check the windshield washer fluid here and replenish it if it's low. Be sure to use a washer fluid like GM OptiClean, not water. Checking the automatic transmission fluid level accurately can be difficult, so you may choose to leave it to the dealership during regular scheduled maintenance. This is also true for the brake master cylinder. You can check the level yourself, but you might want to leave it to the pros to fill it. Let your dealer's service department take care of your brakes, and be sure to tell them if you have any problem with your Chevrolet's braking performance. That's our tour under the hood. As we said, your dealer's service department can perform these vital checks, but it's a good idea for you to keep an eye on things in between service visits as well. It's a great way to help keep your Chevrolet running smoothly and safely. You not only bought your new Chevrolet truck for its looks, more than likely you intend to put it to work and do some towing or hauling cargo. Keep in mind that your truck was designed as a load-carrying vehicle. Towing a load like this horse trailer affects your truck's handling, durability, and fuel economy. If you tow a trailer that's too heavy, you might lose control of your truck. The maximum trailer weight your truck can tow depends primarily on how it's equipped. Its engine and transmission type, axle ratio, and hitch design are key factors. Before hitching up a trailer to your Chevrolet truck, check your owner's manual for advice on proper trailer towing. This manual, along with knowledge of your truck's equipment, will allow you to determine its towing capacity. You can also determine towing capacity by sending an inquiry to the address given in the Warranty and Owner Assistance Information Guide. If your trailer is equipped with its own brakes, make sure they're working by trying them out and becoming familiar with them before you drive in traffic. Reduce speed and shift your transmission into a lower gear before attempting a long downhill stretch. You won't have to use your brakes as much and risk overheating them, and you'll have improved handling capability too. For extended uphill driving, also drive in a lower gear. It reduces the risk of overheating. Speaking of overheating, be aware that towing puts a strain on your vehicle's cooling system. So check the coolant level and the condition of hoses and hose connections before you hit the road. And maybe review the owner's manual section dealing with overheating as well. Proper load distribution and safe tie down are as important to understand as safe towing. First of all, the load capacity of your vehicle is determined by weight as well as volume. To determine how much weight your Chevrolet truck can carry, open the driver's door and read this label. It's called the Vehicle Certification Label. It tells you the maximum weight that each axle, front or back, can support. It also gives you the GVWR, or maximum total weight, including the vehicle, driver, passengers, and cargo. The person to ask about the maximum payload your Chevrolet truck can carry is your service advisor. Don't hesitate to call for information about the carrying capacity of your truck. How you distribute a load is also important. Generally, you'll want to keep the load distributed as evenly as possible in three ways. First, the load should be as low and close to the truck bed as possible to keep the center of gravity as low as possible. Second, keep the load as close to an imaginary center line drawn down the length of the cargo area as you can, and evenly from left to right to prevent tipping from side to side. And third, distribute the load evenly over both front and rear axles. Too much weight behind the rear axle can make the steering light. Too much weight toward the front axle can cause oversteering. Overloading is a potential safety hazard and is an almost sure way to shorten the lifespan of your Chevrolet truck, so think light. Go ahead, enjoy yourself. You're driving one of the best-built vehicles on the road. If you bought an Astro van with all-wheel drive, you've got maximum traction at all times from this full-time system. There are no levers to shift or buttons to push. But remember, like any other vehicle, you must slow down on slippery surfaces. If your truck is equipped with optional four-wheel drive, you'll be ready for just about any terrain. Almost all four-wheel drive Chevrolet trucks feature fully automatic locking hubs. Shifting into four-wheel operation is a breeze. A few models have manual hub locks, depending on particular specifications. Check your owner's manual for hub locking instructions. Okay, now, How about when to use four-wheel drive's traction advantages? Your four-wheel drive was designed to be used on low-traction road surfaces to get you through snow and ice and for off-road use. Four-wheel driving over dry pavement will cause increased tire wear and reduced fuel economy. By the way, even if you're experienced with four-wheel drive, review the four-wheel drive section of your owner's manual, because not all GM systems are alike. One last tip. Chevrolet cares about the environment and wants to encourage safe, responsible use of four-wheel drive vehicles. Ask your dealer for this 4x4 brochure, which contains off-road driving guidelines. So have some fun, but be smart about your off-road adventures. Spotting trouble early is the best way to avoid costly repairs. If there's a problem, it may be indicated by a warning light or a gauge on your dashboard. Warning lights come on when you first start the engine as part of a system's self-check. They should remain on only a moment. But if they remain on or come on while you're underway, you may have a problem. Check your owner's manual or call the dealership for help. This oil gauge indicates your truck is operating under low oil pressure. This battery light could indicate a charging problem with your battery. And this gauge measures engine operating temperature. If the indicator reaches the overheat markings, stop the vehicle right away. Then check the owner's manual for what to do next. If there's an indication that your truck is running hot, but you can't see or hear steam, the problem may not be too serious, especially if you've been climbing a long hill on a hot day, or sitting in stop-and-go traffic for some time, or towing a trailer. You can try to cool the engine by turning off your air conditioner, or if you're stuck in traffic, shifting into N or neutral and increasing the engine's RPMs by slightly depressing the accelerator pedal. If the light stays on or a high gauge reading persists, stop the truck and follow the procedure in your owner's manual. You can also call your dealer's service representative for advice. If the service engine soon or check engine light comes on, don't panic. It's a reminder that your electronic engine or computer-controlled system needs service. No matter which instrument cluster your new Chevrolet truck has, remember, if a warning light comes on or a gauge reads outside the safe range, don't ignore it. Stop the truck and refer to your owner's manual. If you have to, call your dealer's service department for help. Here's another early warning sign. Check the parking surface under your truck every week or so. Fresh puddles of fluid could be an indication that vital fluids are leaking. Here's what to look for. Greenish coolant mixture. Clear or amber engine oil. Purplish red automatic transmission fluid. Dark brown or gray manual transmission fluid or transfer case oil. These could all be serious warning signs. You should contact your dealer's service department immediately to avoid damages that might require extensive repairs. If the fluid spots are water, there's nothing to worry about. It may simply be condensation from the air conditioner. You can also avoid problems by checking your tires every month. Look for signs of wear or damage, and be sure to rotate them at the interval specified in your maintenance schedule. The tire placard inside the door shows the proper inflation pressure for your tires when they're cold. Check the tire pressure once a month, and while you're at it, don't forget to check the pressure of your spare. And if you hear any abnormal sounds, it's a tip-off that there might be trouble, so be aware of how your truck is running. It's important that you know how to spot the early signs of trouble, for if you take care of your new Chevrolet, it will always be ready to go when you are. If you're like most new truck owners, keeping your truck looking good is important. Your owner's manual has a special appearance care section that's worth checking out. It's full of tips on what cleaning products to use and even on how to remove tough stains from upholstery. GM offers a wide variety of cleaning products that are specifically formulated to help you keep your Chevrolet truck looking good inside and out. If you take your truck to the local car wash, make sure there's plenty of clearance on top and by the side mirrors. or you might end up with a nice, clean, damaged truck. Also keep in mind that hot wax can leave a residue on the windshield and other glass that's difficult to remove and makes it harder to see in the rain. If you do opt for the hot wax, clean the windshield and windows with a non-abrasive cleaner. The glass is clear of residue if beads do not form when you rinse with clean water. Ask the manager of the car wash if they use abrasive cleaning brushes. Brushes with silicone carbide bristles can damage your aluminum wheels. You've got a terrific looking truck, and it doesn't take much to keep it that way. Maintaining your vehicle's appearance will also enhance its resale value. It's unlikely that you'll ever get a flat tire, but if you do, it's not difficult to change. Before we show you how, please keep two important safety cautions in mind. Once you start changing the tire, you don't want the truck to move at all, so make sure it's stable. And during the tire change, don't let anyone get under the truck. So let's do it. First step is to read up on the procedure in the owner's manual. Here's how it goes. Park the truck on level ground, a safe distance away from traffic lanes. Put the shift lever in park if you have automatic drive, and reverse or R if it's a manual shift. If your vehicle has four-wheel drive, make sure the transfer case is not in the neutral position. Otherwise, it can roll, even if your regular transmission is in park or manual transmission is in reverse. Turn the engine off, firmly set the parking brake, and turn the hazard warning flashers on. Use wheel chocks, wooden blocks, bricks, or rocks if you have to block the wheel diagonally across from the flat, and block both sides of the wheel, front and back. Now get the spare and jacking tools. Consult your owner's manual for their location in your model. Now it's time to position the jack and raise it until it just touches the vehicle, without raising the vehicle yet. Because jack points and jacking procedures differ from model to model, and according to whether front or rear tire replacement is necessary, consult your owner's manual. Remove the wheel trim or cover carefully, using the chisel end of the socket wrench. If you have a sport wheel cover, don't try to loosen the simulated lug nuts. They're part of the wheel cover, and trying to loosen them will cause damage. Next, use the socket wrench to loosen but not remove the wheel nuts. Now, raise the vehicle on the jack. Once you've jacked the vehicle to a point where the flat just clears the ground, remove the wheel nuts and flat tire. Then, install the spare and hand thread the wheel nuts with the tapered end toward the wheel hub and get them hand snug. Now, lower the vehicle by turning the jack handle counterclockwise. Tighten the wheel nuts in a crisscross sequence by turning the wrench clockwise. Follow the correct tightening sequence illustrated in your owner's manual. Here's the tightening pattern for Chevrolet trucks with 8 lug nuts, for Chevrolet trucks with 6 nuts, and for those with 5. Once the spare is properly mounted, stow and secure the flat and all the jacking equipment in their proper places. It's important to stop somewhere as soon as you can and have the nuts tightened with a torque wrench to the proper specification listed in your owner's manual. That's it. You're ready to get underway. One of your first stops should be a service center to get the tire repaired or replaced. If replacement is necessary, have the tire dealer match the tire performance criteria specification number and the size, these numbers molded into the sidewall, to a new tire. Matching the TPC spec number and size means that your new tire will match the old ones. As we showed you, changing a flat tire isn't a difficult task. Read your owner's manual and get familiar with the procedure. You never know when a flat may happen to you. When you bought your Chevrolet truck, you made a substantial investment. To protect that investment and to get the dependable service your Chevrolet truck is engineered to deliver, you need to make sure that it's maintained regularly. And there's no better place to have that done than in your Chevrolet truck dealer's service department. Your new Chevrolet truck comes equipped with electronic ignition and fuel injection systems, as well as computer-aided diagnosis and emission control devices. Servicing trucks with such advanced technology under the hood is not simple. It takes specially trained technicians and sophisticated equipment to maintain and repair today's Chevrolet. Warranties like the ones covering your new Chevrolet truck can be voided by improper repairs. So as soon as you're ready for your truck's first scheduled maintenance visit, get to know your dealer's service advisor. The service advisor is there to help you keep your Chevrolet truck in prime condition. The service advisors are also your direct link to the service technicians who are trained to care for your truck. Many of them wear this automotive service excellence patch, a sign that they've demonstrated their competence by passing tough, industry-supported certification tests. Exactly how they will care for your truck during scheduled maintenance visits depends on the type of driving you do and your truck's age and mileage. The maintenance schedule in the back of your owner's manual outlines two different maintenance schedules, Schedule 1 and Schedule 2. It's up to you to decide which one is the best suited to the way you drive your truck. Most people's driving habits call for maintenance Schedule 1. Schedule 1 applies if your truck is mainly driven under one or more of the following conditions. When most trips are less than 4 miles. When most trips are less than 10 miles and outside temperatures remain below freezing. When most trips include extended idling and/or frequent low-speed operation, as in stop-and-go traffic. If you tow a trailer with your truck or drive the truck on dusty roads. If any of these conditions describe your driving conditions, you should maintain your truck according to Maintenance Schedule 1. And that means, first and foremost, having the oil and filter changed every 3,000 miles or 3 months, whichever comes first. Now, if none of those conditions applies to the way you drive, then maintain your truck according to Maintenance Schedule 2, which means coming in for your first regular scheduled maintenance visit at 7,500 miles. If you have any doubt about which maintenance schedule to follow, or if your Chevrolet has high performance options, follow Schedule 1 or ask your service advisor for advice. When you do bring the truck in for a visit, the regular scheduled maintenance may include an engine oil and oil filter change, chassis lubrication, transmission or transaxle service, tire and wheel inspection and rotation, checking and replacing air cleaner and PCV filters, checking fuel line and gas filler cap, inspecting spark plug wires and spark plug replacement. Brake maintenance is another service best left to the professionals. Your new truck features a highly engineered GM braking system, which your dealer's service technicians will check during regular maintenance visits. Brake pads are an example of what automotive engineers call wear items. That is, they wear as they do their job, in this case, stopping the truck. GM disc pads are designed to tell you loud and clear when they need replacing. They have a built-in wear indicator that makes a high-pitched squealing sound when new pads are needed. The sound may come and go, or be heard all the time when the vehicle is moving and you push the brake pedal firmly. If you hear this, take the truck in and have the brakes inspected. Occasional intermittent brake squeak is perfectly normal, as long as the truck is stopping properly. Of course, if your brakes begin to operate erratically, pulling to one side or engaging unevenly, you should have them serviced right away, whether or not they are making an abnormal sound. Your dealer has the personnel and equipment to do these routine but important maintenance operations and do them right. All you have to do is follow the recommended schedule. Take the truck in and then keep a careful record of all maintenance work performed right here in this section of your maintenance schedule, the maintenance record. Winter and summer driving can be rough on any truck. One good way to help your truck survive the effects of winter's cold and summer's heat is to do some preventive maintenance. Check in with your dealer, say, in April or May, and again in October or November. At each interval, the service technicians will check your coolant mixture for proper strength and freshness, and take a look at the hoses, hose connections, and belts. Things you can do yourself include spraying silicone lubricant on a clean cloth and applying a thin film around the weather stripping on the doors. In the spring, try the air conditioner to make sure it's working properly. In the fall, make sure the heater defroster is functioning properly before the cold weather sets in. In cold climates, gearing up for winter might also mean carrying some emergency supplies on board, like an ice scraper, a small brush or broom, a supply of windshield washer fluid, a rag, some winter outer clothing, a shovel, a flashlight, a red cloth, and a couple of reflective warning triangles. If you will be driving under severe conditions, include a small bag of sand, a piece of old carpet, or a couple of burlap bags for traction, and possibly a set of tire chains. With these items, you're ready for almost any minor emergency in almost any weather. So there you have it, important truck care facts and tips you need to know in order to get peak performance from your new truck. But there's still one more thing you can do, this time to help us out. We want you to be completely satisfied with your new Chevrolet truck and with your dealership services. So if you have any questions about the operation, maintenance, or warranties on your new truck, speak to your service department. That's what they're there for. And please be sure to fill out and return any GM surveys you receive. Your response is important to us because it lets us know how we're doing and any way we can improve. We try our best to provide the most professional, courteous service you can find. If you're happy, let us know on the surveys by checking very satisfied. But if at any time you're not satisfied with the attention we give you or your truck, please come talk to us. We look forward to seeing you at your first regular scheduled maintenance visit. Meanwhile, have fun getting acquainted with your new Chevrolet truck. Good luck, and keep on trucking.